So in packet monitoring, a monitor might see the full packet contents, or at least the packet headers that traverse a particular link. Common ways of performing packet monitoring that you may have tried yourself include TCP dump, Ethereal, or Wireshark. And in some of the exercises, you'll get a chance to explore packet monitoring with one of these tools. Sometimes packet monitoring is performed using expensive hardware that can be mounted in servers alongside the routers that forward traffic through the network. In these cases, an optical link in the network is sometimes split so that traffic can be both sent along the network and sent to the monitor. Even though packet monitoring sometimes requires this expensive hardware on very high-speed links, what you do when you run TCP dump or Wireshark or Ethereal is essentially the same thing. Your machine acts as a monitor on the local area network, and if any packets happen to be sent towards your network interface, the network interface records those packets. Now, on a switch network, you wouldn't see many packets that weren't destined for your own MAC address. But on a network where there's a lot of traffic being flooded, you might see quite a bit more traffic destined for an interface that you're using to monitor. So the advantages of packet monitoring is that it provides lots of detail. You can see timing information and information in the packet headers. Unfortunately, a disadvantage is that it's fairly high overhead. It is very hard to keep up with high-speed links and often requires a separate monitoring device, such as the monitoring card that we've shown here. What if we are happy with a little less detail than packet monitoring can provide, but we can't afford its overhead? In that case, there is actually another approach that we can use called flow monitoring.